I'm here at the Jefferson Community and Technical College's Carrollton campus, where some Oldham County students take part in a program where school is only 2 days per week and receive dual credit for the college-level courses that they take.
Located at a scenic spot along the Ohio River is a quaint building that is home to JCTC's Carrollton campus, along with over 30 students from OC that attend school there.
It to me adds one more layer of actual adult survival living.
Chris White teaches a religion class to Oldham County students and says that the style of JCTC is a bit different from what high schoolers may normally experience.
This is not heavy on socialization. It is heavy on content, heavy on intensity when you're here, and then when you're gone, you've got to manage the time.
Susan Hack, another professor at the Carrollton campus, agrees.
If you procrastinate and put it off, the classes will really snowball on you. And once you get behind, it's difficult, very difficult, to catch up.
While the workload may be difficult, the program is a good way to help with the transition between high school and college.
Well, in our classes, there's a lot more discussion and more of a freedom of ideas rather than sitting down and being fed information and then spitting it back out on a test.
A real sense of vision for college, a good head start on college, and I think they would have made that transition to already being, in their mind, college students.
Students are also able to still be involved with their senior class back at home.
Well, I come back for band every day, and so I'm still involved in that way. We could just come back whenever we want to take part in pep rallies or what's going on.
Some final words of advice from Carrollton's Dino class professor for current juniors considering the program for next year.
It helps them to reduce their student loan debt in the future, get into the workplace faster, and that boils down to essentially being an adult that has more money. And money is good!
This has been Sarah Boyney reporting for OTVX.